initiating world of causes. Historical conditions, the relationships between nations, social taboos, religious convictions and tendencies can all be traced to originating causes, some of them most ancient. Everything that is happening in the world today and which is so potently affecting humanity, things of beauty and of horror, modes of living and civilization and culture, prejudices and likings, scientific attainment and artistic expression and the many ways in which humanity throughout the planet colors existence, are aspects of effects, initiated somewhere, on some level at some time, by human beings, both individually and en masse. Karma is therefore that which man, the heavenly man in whom we live, humanity as a whole, mankind in groups as nations, and individual man, has instituted, carried forward, endorsed, omitted to do or has done right through the ages until the present moment. Today, the harvest is ripe and mankind is reaping what it has sown, preparatory to a fresh plowing in the springtime of the new age, with a fresh sowing of the seed which will, let us pray and hope, produce a better harvest. The outstanding evidence of the law of cause and effect is the Jewish race. All nations prove this law, but I choose to refer to the Hebrew peoples because their history is so well known and their future and their destiny are subjects of worldwide, universal concern. The Jews have copyright 1998 Lucas Trust 156, A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. Always had a symbolic significance, they sum up in themselves, as a nation, down the ages, the depths of human evil and the heights of human divinity. Their aggressive history as narrated in the Old Testament is on a par with present-day German accomplishment, yet Christ was a Jew and it was the Hebrew race which produced him. Let this never be forgotten. The Jews were great aggressors. They despoiled the Egyptians and they took the promised land at the point of the sword, sparing neither man, woman nor child. Their religious history has been built around a materialistic Jehovah, possessive, greedy and endorsing and encouraging aggression. Their history is symbolic of the history of all aggressors, rationalizing themselves into the belief that they are carrying out divine purpose, wresting away from people their property in a spirit of self-defense and finding some reason, adequate to them, to excuse the iniquity of their action. Palestine was taken by the Jews because it is a land flowing with milk and honey, and the claim was made that the act was undertaken in obedience to divine command. Later, the symbolism gets most interesting. They divide it into two halves. The Israelites with headquarters at Samaria, and the Jews meaning two or three special tribes out of the 12 rotating around Jerusalem. Dualism ran through their religious beliefs. They were schooled by the Sadducees or the Pharisees, and these two groups were in constant conflict. Christ came as a member of the Jewish race and they renounced him. Today the law is working, and the Jews are paying the price, factually and symbolically, for all they have done in the past. They are demonstrating the far-reaching effects of the law. Christ within, as they did centuries ago, the Christ within their borders, grasping for material good and steadily rejecting the things of the Spirit. They demand the so-called restitution of Palestine, wresting it away from those who have inhabited it for many centuries, and by their continued emphasis upon material possession, they lose sight of the true solution, which is that, symbolically and factually again, they must be assimilated into all the nations, and fused with all the races, thus demonstrating recognition of the one humanity. It is interesting to note that the Jews who inhabited southern Palestine, and whose chief city was Jerusalem, have succeeded in doing this and have fused with and been assimilated by the British, the Dutch and the French in a way that the Israelites, ruled from St. Maria, have never done. I commend this to you for your consideration. Copyright 1998 Lucis Trust. 157. A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. If the Jewish race would recall, therefore, their high symbolic destiny, and if the rest of humanity would see themselves in the Jewish people, and if both groups would emphasize the fact of human stop and cease thinking of themselves in terms of national and racial units, the karma of humanity would radically change from the retributive karma of the present to the recompensing good karma of the future. Regarding this question from the long-range vision, looking backward historically as well as forward hopefully, the problem is one to which the Jews themselves must make the larger contribution. They have never yet faced candidly and honestly, as a race, the problem of why the many nations, from the time of the Egyptians, have neither liked nor wanted them. It has always been the same down the centuries. Yet there must be some reason, inherent in the people themselves, when the reaction is so general and universal. Their approach to their direful problem has been one of supplication, or of distressed complaint, or of unhappy despair. Their demand has been for the Gentile nations to put the matter right, and many Gentiles have attempted to do so. Until, however, the Jews themselves face up to the situation and admit that there may be for them the working out of the retributive aspect of the law of cause and effect, and until they endeavor to ascertain what it is in them, as a race, which has initiated their ancient and dire fate, this basic world issue will remain as it has been since the very night of time. That within the race there are and have been great, good, just and spiritual men is unalterably true. A generalization is never a complete expression of the truth. But, viewing the problem of the Jews in time and space, in history and today, the points which I have made will bear careful consideration by the Jews. What I have said in no way mitigates the guilt of those who have so sorely abused the Jews. You have a proverb, have you not, that two blacks do not make a white. The behavior of the nations towards the Jews, culminating in the atrocities of the second quarter of the 20th century, have no excuse. The law must inevitably work. That has happened to the Jews originated in their past history and in their pronounced attitude of separativeness and non-assimilability, and in their emphasis upon material good, yet the agents who have brought the evil karma upon them equally incur the retributive aspect of the same law. The situation has now assumed the form of a vicious circle of error and wrongdoing, of retribution and revenge, and in view of this the time must come when together the nations will confer upon this problem, and together they will cooperate to bring to an end the wrong attitudes on both sides. civilization, the cultural background, and the standards of living of the nation to which, by copyright 1998 vs. Trust. 158. The Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. The Fact of Birth and Education, He's Related and with which He should assimilate. By the relinquishment of pride of race and of the concept of selectivity, it will come by renouncing dogmas and customs which are intrinsically obsolete and which create points of constant irritation to the matrix within which the Jew finds himself. It will come when selfishness in business relations and the pronounced manipulative tendencies of the Hebrew people are exchanged for more selfless and honest forms of activity. Recognize and not seek as he now does to dominate in all fields, to grasp all opportunities away from other people, and so better himself and his own people at the expense of others. Release from the present situation will come when the Jew forgets that he is a Jew and becomes in his inmost consciousness an Italian, an American, a Britisher, a German, or a Pole. This is not so at this time. The Jewish problem will be solved by intermarriage, that of the Negro will not. This will mean concession and compromise on the part of the Orthodox Jews, not the concession of expediency but the concession of conviction. Let me point out also that just as